We live in a world of radiation. Light, heat, microwaves, and wireless communications are all forms of radiation. Some radiation is ionizing, meaning it can produce charged particles called ions. Background radiation is all around us. It comes from many sources, including the sun, building materials. We find it in our homes, in things like smoke detectors, and even in our foods. But how do we see radiation? You can't see, hear, feel, smell, or taste radiation, but you can see it using a cloud chamber, like the one we have here. This cloud chamber contains alcohol vapor. As the radiation passes through, it leaves a trail behind which can only be seen in this kind of environment. What you're seeing here though is just normal air and the background radiation that's around us all of the time. You can see that different kinds of radiation produce different shaped trails. For example, alpha particles produce short, broad trails, whereas beta particles produce long, thin trails. So how much radiation does a worker at ANSTO actually receive? All radiation workers wear a personal dosimetry device to measure their exposure to radiation. Exposure to ionizing radiation is measured in units called a sievert. The sievert is quite a large unit, so it's normal to measure exposure in microsieverts, or a millionth of a sievert. The average Australian's radiation dose is 1,500 microsieverts per year. The average radiation dose of an ANSTO worker is 1,750 microsieverts per year. In comparison, the average dose for a crew member of an international airline is 4,000 microsieverts per year. Or if you work in Cornwall, UK, the average dose is 7,800 microsieverts per year. The increased background radiation levels are due to the higher levels of radon gas. The lowest annual dose with links to long-term health effects is 100,000 microsieverts per year. This is more than 50 times the amount that the average Australian would receive in a year. For more information, head to ansto.gov.au.